Warren Depew was walking this very beach, 5 miles south of Pentwater, when he picked up a bottle with a message inside.
The bottle outlined what the chief engineer and the captain of the tug, James Martin, had already told the fuming community of Menominee. Their former undersheriff and Captain Axel Larson were abandoned off Poverty Island when the Martin started sinking in the 1913 storm. "Goodbye, dear ones. I might see you in heaven," is how Chris Keenan said goodbye. But a postscript was added that Charles Hubel owed him $35 for protecting his interest in the schooner that was now on the bottom of Lake Michigan.
The captain of the Isolde Bach actually found the body of Chris Keenan right here. The body of the captain, Axel Larson, was found just south of here near Muskegon. Other crew members were never found, and the mystery of the Plymouth is still yet to be solved.
The tug James Martin sank in the harbor. One owner was in jail, the other losing his license for hiring a captain that wasn't licensed for the trip to the Straits. But the story doesn't end there. Bottled Goodbyes takes an in-depth look at the Plymouth and Light Vessel 82, two messages of over a half dozen that were found after the great storm.
You can learn more about the Plymouth and the 1913 storm in my new book, Bottled Goodbyes. Also look for my book, The Wheelsman, with eyewitness accounts from that storm and many others, and my DVD, Final Run, which is also available at maritime museums and online at lakefury.com.